Hello to everyone. In this video, I'm going to explain how to plot a bar graph of different length, height, width and color, and also I'm going to explain how to group them. Now first of all, you need to write certain commands: clc, clear all and close all. These are the commands to clear the command window. Now you are going to take an input from the user. There are two ways of taking the input: either you can take it directly from the user or you can take it in the form of array. Now here I am taking it in the form of array. Y equal to 22, 44, 55 and 66. Bar is the command to draw it in the command window. Now we are going to run it and see the output on the command window. Here you can see the color is blue. If you want to change the color, you just need to write the color in the inverted commas. Here green. Let's see the output. We have chosen the green. Now here you can see that the color of this bar graph has been changed to green. Now if you change the width of this bar graph, then you need to write the width after y, 0.40. This will change the width to 40% of the earlier width. Now you will find the width will be changed. Let's see the output on command window. Here you can see that the width of the bar graph has been changed. Now if you want to change the value of the x-axis, then for that you need to write x, and here I want to start from 100. For that 100, and then time interval and limit up to which I want to go. You need to make sure that number of sample of this x and y are equal. Now we are going to run it. Bar xy 0.40 green. Here you can see that number start from 100, then 110, 120 and 130. Now we are going to group two graphs together. Now grouping means we are going to plot two samples in a one block or n samples in a one block. Here we are going to plot two samples in a one block. YY equal 10, 30, 44, 33. So two samples will be created. Let's draw it bar YY and see the output on the command window. Here you can see that they are grouped in two. First one is first and second one is second. Now if I want to convert them into the stack form, then I need to write a stack, and here you can see that they are converted into the stack form. Now I can also define the value on the x-axis. Suppose I want to represent first data with 1996 and second with 1997, then I need to write x equal to 1996. One is the interval and 1997 is the final value. So here you can see the output on the command window. Now I want to change the color of the edge. For that I need to write edge color, and after that I need to write the color which I want. Here I am writing red. Now I am going to run it and see the output on command window. Here you can see that the edge line is red. Now you can also change the width of that line by using the command line width, and after that I need to specify the width 1.5 here. Run it and see the output. Here you can see that the width is changed to 1.5. Now I'm going to take an example where I'm going to group various frequency distribution together. Here suppose I'm having group of four data and we are having total of two samples, and data are 11, 22, 33, 44, 22, 55, 66 and 77, and the interval value varies from 1997 to 1998. So I need to write 1997 interval is 1 and final interval is 1998. Now I'm going to plot a bar using the bar command, bar zz, and I'm going to group them. We need to write group for that. Bar zz grouped. And we're going to run it on the command window. Let's see the output. Here you can see that the color is blue and blue, sky blue, yellow and brown. If you want to change the color, then that can be also possible in MATLAB. For that, you need to make use of a property set RR first parameter, and I need to write face color and the color which I want for the first bar. Face color, suppose I want a red color, then I need to write red. Similarly, we can define it for the other bars. Before that, let's see the output. Here you can see that first color is changed to red. Now if I want to change the color of other bars, then I need to copy it and paste it 3 times. Now RR2, RR3, RR4, and we need to change the color here. B for blue, yellow and green. Now we are going to run it and see the output on command window. Here the color is changed to red, blue, yellow and green. Now after this, if I want to represent the value of this parameter at the top, for that I need to first make a one collection or array. First of all, we need to make a one array AA. Now this is a collection of elements: red, blue. Here, green, yellow, green. Now I am going to make use of the legend command to plot this value on the top of the command window. So legend AA location, we can plot at any location. Here we are going to plot at northeast, so we will write northeast. Northeast. And now we are going to see the output on command window. We are going to run this program. And here you can see that these have come to the top right side. Now if I want to take it to the left side, then I need to write north west instead of northeast. So I will modify this last word and write it as northwest. And now I am going to run it again and see the output on command window. Here you can see that color is red, blue, yellow and green, and the